welcome to this wonderful celebration of Mahatma Gandhi's birth anniversary. He walked the earth in flesh and blood, but came to be known as the Mahatma, or the great soul. His evolution from a shy, retiring young man to a sage who rocked the foundations of the British Empire was a monumental journey. This transformation came at the expense of huge personal cost, made by him, by his family, as well as his followers, as they undertook the journey with him.
Gandhi's biggest strength was that he practiced what he preached. Practicing what you preach is extremely challenging.
As usual, it never ceases to amaze, and you know, wonderful thoughts there that have been said, putting into practice what we preach, because often our preachings do not dovetail with our actions. So, you know, that is very well said. So, you know, we should always be mindful of whatever you might say. You might give big, long speeches, but your actions and what you've actually done will prove what and who you are.
The Mahatma's greatest contribution, friends, is, however, to awaken the often dormant humanity in each one of us, not only spiritually, but also socially and politically. His ability to take on the might of the British Empire with all its tyranny and exploitation, without uttering an unkind word against them, has become an inspiration for all those fighting oppression and injustice and discrimination.
This statue was flown from Delhi by the Indian High Commission in Canberra all the way here to come in time, you know, for the inaugural. Now, Modiji's story was that from Modiji, who was just Mr. Modi, eventually in 2014 also became the Prime Minister of India. And obviously in G20, he will be the one as head of the state will be visiting here. And that's exactly what happened. So I mean, the good stars are colliding after 13 years. Imagine a person we met over a dinner and suddenly he becomes the Prime Minister of India and comes here to unveil the statue. So anyway, that's mainly the story about this statue. We've got hundreds of photographs. We've got, you know, the committee, MGMC committee was formed, you know, with AIBC, you know, Gopio, and FICQ, and I'm glad to see that, you know, after that, as Umesh Ji said, you know, before the statue, you know, we used to come here for celebrating Mahatma Gandhi Jayanti, but now it has become a little bit more formal. And then the bridge, which was also announced on the same day Modi Ji inaugurated the statue, so the two very big landmarks we have, one in, here in Brisbane, one in Ipswich, and it's a good time that we connect both on this day, and every year we continue to celebrate this very important day.
He was truly one of India's greatest sons. His philosophy, his methodology reflected the finest distillation of India's many traditions and came to inspire many struggles of freedom and independence all over the world.
It's indeed a great moment for us today, as we are celebrating 152nd birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhiji, whose ideology and beliefs have changed the course of history. Non-violence becomes widely known when promoted by Mahatma Gandhiji. Mahatma Gandhiji is one of the most famous leaders and champions for justice. He has been followed by many others important leaders in the world like Martin Luther King Jr., Nelson Mandela. Truth and nonviolence are the two pillars on which rested the magnificent and glorious life and work of Mahatma Gandhiji.
Mahatma Gandhi was a Yug Purush, not only for the times that he lived in, but for all times to come. He will continue to inspire humanity for as long as humanity is around. On his birth anniversary, we remember him, we honor his memory, his legacy, and his contributions to the world at large. And I wish you a very, very happy Gandhi Jayanti, so we may all take a leaf from his book and maybe try and shape our actions according to the great Mahatma.